It isolated me away from my family and my friends, and I always thought of how can, you know, I change and become better to where, you know, he wouldn't hit me anymore.
I was never good enough. I was too fat. I was too ugly. I wasn't smart enough. I wasn't pretty. I'd go in the bathroom and put on a little bit of makeup for him, and it was, who are you going to screw today?
He was actually putting me on dating websites, essentially trying to drug me and sell me out to other men.
He raped me, he touched me, he choked me, he bumped my head on the coffee table. I was bleeding.
When you lock your door at night, you protect yourself from the people on the outside. Well, when I locked my door, I trapped myself in my house with the one that was going to do the harm.
He hit my son with an extension cord.
Not my child. Not my children. You can hit me all day, but you won't hit my kids. You won't hit my children.
And I just want to give up because I am tired. I am really tired of making the family work. I was desperate, I was frustrated, and the most devastating part is being hopeless. The first thing they do is to give you the safety and the security. Safe is their priority.
They offered me housing, a safety plan, and mostly provided the emotional counseling that I need to help me move from that victim mentality to one of strength, confidence, empowerment.
It's encouragement enough to just want to keep on and to keep pressing on, and that everything will be okay, everything will be all right.
Just having somebody to call and say, I'm having a bad day, I need to talk to somebody. I could call and come in anytime and they would talk to me. I was able to go back to school because I felt like I was smart enough to do it. I knew that I could do it now.
Even though they were strangers, they had become my family. They had become friends.
Nobody extended a helping hand, but you were there. You have treated me with respect and dignity, in which I really, really, certainly appreciate that. You did not let me down.
It was more than a job for them, that they were saving lives. And they saved mine.